Before I begin my review of Spider-Man to the Spider-Verse by Peter Ramsay, I just have something to say. I'm a very big fan of Spider-Man. Once I heard there's an animated Spider-Man movie with good character development, comic book art style, and an amazing soundtrack to go with it, I knew this was going to be a good movie. I know this movie's been praised to no end, and it did win the Oscar for Best Animated Movie of the Year. But it's my turn too, okay? When I left the theater after watching this movie for the first time, I felt completely satisfied in every way about a film. The first thing you're going to notice is the look of the movie. The team behind Into the Spider-Verse wanted to have the look of the film to be straight out of a comic, animating in the Ben Day dot process. This process uses equally distant dots on a grid with color to create the retro comic book art style. Initially caught me off guard for the first time, but my eyes got adjusted within the first 5 minutes, and even after rewatches, the art style feels completely normal. This film is about a teen named Miles Morales from Brooklyn, New York, who gets bit by a radioactive spider. Miles must now learn how to handle his new superpowers to become the new Spider-Man with help from his alternate dimensional Spider-Man. This follows the popular hero's journey with three acts. This movie does a pretty good job with pacing. This starts out with from a normal day in Miles's life moving into getting bitten and then finding another Spider-Man. I often felt engaged with the story and I didn't find myself questioning characters' motivations or feelings, and that is a good thing to have in a movie. The movie slowly introduces us to more Spider-Men as Miles tries to stop Wilson Fisk, the main antagonist of the movie, from detonating a multi-dimensional collider from destroying New York. Each character has their own animation style and colors that complement their design. For example, Spider-Man Noir has a distinct black and white look, giving an old 1930s feel, while another character, Penny Parker, has a heavy focus on the anime art style with red and blue colors. Characters never feel out of place in shots. These two characters can be in the same scene with different art styles and still flow seamlessly together. Even the villains are written and look like compelling antagonists. Every frame with Wilson Frisk takes up almost se he takes up almost 70% of the screen, just to give it a sense of a powerful villain for Miles. My favorite villain of the movie is the Prowler, Uncle Davis to Miles, and a key character in Miles' journey becoming Spider-Man. He has his own distinct distorted siren that gives me chills just hearing. He acts like Spider-Man's cool uncle, but he does work for Mr. Frisk as the Prowler who hunts the Spider-Man. I had a real moment of sadness when Uncle Aaron dies and his death actually impacts Miles' story to become a true Spider-Man. This moment of sadness is called catharsis, when a release of strong emotions is and has helped to push the narrative of the story going into the final act. Into the Spider-Verse is a love letter to anything Spider-Man. It has plenty of fan service with jokes and nods to previous versions of Spider-Man, as well as a few reference shots or familiar imagery. An example of this is when we see the original Spider-Man swinging around the collider. Miles thinks to himself how Spider-Man can swing so effortlessly. But towards the end of the film, Miles uses the same technique shown by the original Spider-Man, and his mentor asks where did he learn that, referencing the earlier shot. Familiar imagery helps glue together the story of the film and helps provide a flow and a sense of accomplishment and skill of the. The decision to make the soundtrack in this film more hip hop and rap fits very well with Miles as a teen. This helps him feel a lot more relatable and real rather than just kind of stiff and not a character. There's small details in the soundtrack that you just don't notice. Like when the music stops when Miles' headphones all off, you'll need to rewatch to notice them. Sometimes the movie will have these songs playing in the background of an emotional moment, and they kind of sort of don't fit well with the scene, but this happens like once in the movie and I'll let it slide. This movie has become one of my favorite animated movies of all time, as well as Spider-Man related media. I definitely give this movie a solid 9 out of 10.